Hey, welcome. So, in the last lesson, we talked about just general ideas of what a sequence in a series was, where a sequence is a set of numbers that are in a pattern, and we have to go find that pattern. And a series is, after we've got that sequence of numbers, what happens when we add them up? That's what makes it a series. So now we're going to talk about two specific types. And the first one we're going to talk about is actually arithmetic sequences. So when I talk about an arithmetic sequence, okay, an arithmetic sequence is one where there's a common difference. In other words, I'm going to add something over and over again. So in this particular one where they ask us to find the next four terms in an arithmetic sequence, so when you see the word arithmetic, you're going to be thinking to yourself, hey, I'm going to add or subtract something to get to my next ones here. Add or subtract. Okay. So I'm going to look at those and I go, looks like if I add, what is that? Add up 17. Add a 17. Is that right? 17. It looks like right. If I add 17 to it, they want me to find the next four. There's my common difference. So what I do is I would write down and say, hey, look, my common difference is 17. As it is. And then they wanted to find my next four. Well, that's easy enough to do, right? Add 17 to that, you're going to get negative 2. Maybe if my pen works. Negative 2, add a 17 to that, you get a positive 15. Add a 17 to that, you get a positive 32. And add a 17 to that, you get a positive 49. That wasn't so bad. Okay. So let's take on the next one. You do the next one. Okay. This one shouldn't be too hard, right? I want you to determine the common difference, and I want you to find the next form in the arithmetic sequence. Okay? Again, arithmetic. Pause me, please. Do it right now. And bam, there you go. Hopefully, you've seen that the common difference in this one is that I'm subtracting numbers. So when I subtract that, my common difference is a negative 6. I'm adding a negative 6 each time. Okay? All right. That seems about right. Boom. How do I figure that? So let's go here. Go next. Oops. In fact, this is the key concept for this one, is if I want to find out, I'm going to set up something here. This right here is how I set up a general form of my arithmetic sequence. If I want to find the nth term or any term, like the 22nd term, the 34th term, the nth term. I need to know the first term. I need to know what term I'm looking for, the 22nd, the 34th, and what the common difference is. If I know those three things, I can find any term out there. Okay? Any term for any sequence. It's just kind of cool. This is not only called, finding the nth term of everything, this is also called your explicit form. Explicit form. It's called explicit because in order for me to find out the 22nd term, I plug in 22. In order for me to find the 32nd term, I need just find the 32. And that's all I should need. That's why it's explicit. It's telling me exactly what I need. So when I go to this next one here, and it says find the explicit formula. Hey, I just figured out how that works, right? Explicit formula. That's up front. And then they want me to find a recursive one for the nth term in the sequence. Both of them involve the common difference. Hopefully you can see that the common difference between these two is minus an 11. Boom, minus an 11. Okay. So if I want to find, I go and grab my formula, a sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times the common difference. Well, for my explicit formula, I'm going to keep n. N is my variable. What's my first term? My first term is 14 plus n minus 1 times my common difference, in this case, negative 11. And that's my explicit formula. Boom. Now if I want to, I can carry it out a little bit further. I can multiply out. I can say 14 plus, multiply this out, a negative 11n plus 11. Okay, add this up. This is equal to a 25 minus an 11n. And that could be my explicit formula. Now, how do I find my recursive formula? Well, for my recursive formula, remember, recursive means look back one term. So if I want to build a recursive formula, I know that my nth term relies on my previous term, a sub n minus 1. So what happens? If I want to get this term right here, how do I get, and I'm going to look at this term, so I'm going to look at 14. 14 plus or minus what gets me that? My common difference. So my recursive formula will always be like this for a arithmetic term, or arithmetic sequence. So that means that for this specific one, a sub n minus 1, that does not change. And what's my common difference? My common difference, I found out, was a negative 11, so I can put minus 11. And that's it. So my two final answers are this one here and this one here. Let's take a look at another one. So they want me to find the explicit formula for the nth term, again, arithmetic sequence. So when I see the word arithmetic sequence, I'm thinking adding or subtracting. And obviously these are getting bigger, so I'm adding. But what am I adding? Looks like I'm adding an 18. Adding an 18. Again, I write down what my formula is. My formula for an explicit form is a sub n is equal to my first term plus my second term, n minus 1, times my common difference, 18. I multiply out. This is equal to a 15 plus an 18n minus an 18. And then I make this look pretty by saying this is going to be an 18n. 15 minus an 18, minus a 3. There's one answer. There's my explicit form, because all I do is I plug in n, and that gets me my formula, or my answer. So what about my recursive formula? Again, my recursive formula, a sub n is equal to a sub n minus 1. Oops, let's make that look better. N minus 1. And I'm going to add in my common difference plus, what's my common difference? 18. And there's my recursive formula. Not too terribly difficult, especially the recursive formula. This one, okay, there's a little bit of math. So how can I use this to solve more complicated problems? I'm glad you asked. So now what I'm going to be doing is looking for the nth term. Now they want me to find the 41st term. Take 3. It says find the 41st. Okay. So this time I want to find the 41st term. Well, how do I find the 41st term? I have two ways I could do it. I could do that explicit form or the recursive form. Well, in order to find the 41st term, I would need in the recursive form, I need to find the 40th term and the 39th and the 30th. I don't want to do that. So I'm going to use the explicit form. So again, a sub n is equal to the first term. Do I know the first term? 11. Okay. Plus n minus 1 times my difference. Well, what's my difference? Looks like a negative 7. Negative 7. Negative 7. So again, negative 7. I go ahead and make this look a little prettier. 11 minus a 7n, okay, plus a 7, which is equal to an 18 minus a 7n. So there's a sub n. So now I want to find the 41st term. So I take it one step further. I want to find a sub 41 is equal to 18 minus a 7. Plug in 41 for n, okay, which is equal to 18 minus, looks like a 287, which is then equal to a negative 269. And there's my 41st term. I believe that's right. Yep, it looks good. Okay. Wow. Not too terribly difficult, right? Okay. A little bit of calculator maybe for this if you need it. Let's see what's next. Ooh. Now this one says find the first term of an arithmetic sequence for which a sub 44 is 229 and the difference, the common difference, is 8. So again, let's figure out what my formula is. Remember, I'm going to write it out up top here. I'm going to say a sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times my common difference. Well, look, I can find out a lot of this information. They tell me a sub 44, which is equal to 229. We'll get that in a second. A sub 44, so I'm just going to plug in for 44. Is equal to a sub 1 plus 44 minus 1 times my common difference of 8. Do I know what a 44 is? Yes, it's 229. So 229 is equal to a 1 plus, I can do this, this is 43 times 8. And now it's just a matter of multiplying and subtracting. Okay, so I have here 229 is equal to a sub 1 plus, it's 32, 24, 344. Subtract 344 from both sides. All right, so subtract 344 from both sides. When I subtract that from both sides, what do I get? Well, this is going to give me a negative 115 is equal to a sub 1. Huh. Again. Not difficult. You just need to know what to do. All right? Those are your steps to be able to figure that out. Let's go ahead and do one more example. All right. So it says here, find the first term. Oops, I already did that one. Let's try this. Let's see. Find the 25th term of an arithmetic sequence. I'm going to leave this one for you. Take the time to do it. We'll see you on the flip side. And bam, there's your answer. All right, again, negative 9 is your common difference, is what you should have seen. Your a sub n term, here's your explicit form right here, right? There's your explicit form. And then plugging in for 25, you should get a sub 25 is equal to negative 167. All right, so we're going to call it there. That's good enough for today. I'll go ahead and get this up, and we hope to see you guys next time. Talk to you guys later. Bye.